Dear patrons, subscribers, and new friends, long time no see. This is Tim. In the previous video, we promised to talk about flight controls. What comes into your mind? Ailerons? Elevators? Rudder? The stick? The yoke? Or, well, maybe the flaps, slats, engine, or even landing gear are flight controls. Anything that the pilot can control and affect flight performance. So, which flight controls matter for taxiing? Rudder, steering wheel. Actually, even ailerons and elevators matter on ground. Why? Let's get into the sim and I'll show you why. Here we have a Cessna Skyhawk 172 in a pretty strong wind condition. Wind is from 343 degrees at 40 knots. And we're heading 343 degrees, so it's a direct headwind of 40 knots as indicated on the airspeed indicator. Let's take a look outside. Here is the aircraft. If I pull back on the yoke, a strong wind can raise the nose. And if I push forward, see, if I push forward in headwind, it helps the nose gear to firmly grip the ground. So imagine when you are taxiing in headwind, you want to push forward on the yoke, so you have better control steering. If I release the brakes now and pull back on the yoke, the strong headwind can actually push us back. So be careful when you have the engines off. Let's take a look at tailwind. ...163 degrees at 40 knots. Now things become opposite. If I pull back on the yoke, the tailwind raise the tail and push the nose down. If I push forward on the yoke, the tailwind pushes the tail down, raise the nose. So when you taxi in the tailwind, what do you want? You want to pull back on the yoke to firmly grip the ground. Now if I release the brakes and push forward, the tailwind, the strong tailwind can actually pushes forward. And not only that, if I don't do anything else, the tailwind will become headwind like this. Let's start the engine and practice taxiing in the strong wind. So beacon lights on. Propeller area is clear. Start the engine. Okay, before we taxi, switch on the taxi lights. So, let's give it some power. Release the brakes. Now, we do it the wrong way first. Back on the yoke, rudder full left. It doesn't want to go to the left. I need to push forward on the yoke to steer to the left. And if I want to go to the right, I will also push forward on the yoke and have the rudder to the right. So let's do it. Now, what about taxiing in a crosswind? Did you see something seems wrong? Oops. What just happened is that when we are in a crosswind, wind is from this direction, and we were a river texting in this direction. So the wind tries to flip us around like that. To counteract this effect, we need to turn the ailerons to the left. So left side up, right side down when we turn left. When we are in the headwind, crosswind, it's the into the wind to counteract the effect, to prevent flipping over. And you can derive that it's the opposite for a tail crosswind. Let's fix the engine. Fix the engine, fix everything. The engine is fixed and we start the engine again. Okay, remember what I said just now? If we go to the right, crosswind will be from the left, so we want to turn into the wind. Okay, let's begin. Forward on the yoke and steer left, so we won't flip it over. And then it becomes tailwind if we don't steer to the left. We would flip to the left, or even flip over, because we also need to pull back on the yoke. So be careful. Now I'm upside down, I guess. Oh, yes. So we were in the headwind. We turn to the right, and it becomes tailwind. Throughout the turn, in the beginning, you push forward, steer left, but as you turn into the crosswind, you neutralize the elevator and also the ailerons, and then to prepare for the tailwind, you pull back and steer the opposite direction of the wind. Let's try again. To the right again. And throttle up, release the brakes. Forward pressure, because it's headwind. And right further, it runs into the wind. And then, as we turn tailwind, do the opposite. Into the wind, into the wind, into the wind, forward, into the wind, into the wind. Try to turn around again. Loop once more. Tailwind, tailwind, just the opposite. You don't want to turn too sharply. So what about to the left? Let's also practice turning left. Forward pressure, it wants to, into the wind. And then it's crosswind, and then it's tailwind, to the opposite. And then it's headwind, so to the wind. Loop one more. Into the wind. It takes some practices, and practice makes perfect. So when you have the opportunity to fly in the sim, even if the wind is not strong, practice these skills so you wouldn't be flipped over in the real world. Before I recap, let me mention that Patrons get to watch our next video before everyone else. So, become a patron today. Alright. In the headwind, push forward to pitch down. Turn the ailerons into the wind. And rudder into the turn, of course. As always, taxi slowly. For tailwind, pull back to pitch down. Turn ailerons opposite to the wind. And if your rudder is not connected to the wheel, rudder opposite to the turn. And again, taxi slowly. Finally, here is some bonus that patrons have already seen. It is important that we have our controllers calibrated when we practice taxiing. So here I have a Cessna ProFlight rudder pedals with toe brakes. On my right, we have the right toe brake as I step it all the way down, it's calibrated. And on my left is the left toe brake, same, it's calibrated. Finally is the rudder axis, all the way left and all the way right, it's all done. And next we'll move on to the stick. So, you twist to the left and twist to the right. Make sure you do it all the way, even though it's already blue, because look at that, it's not centered. All the way right, that's the calibration, okay? For every axis, do it all the way, all the way, all the way. After that, practice, practice, and practice. And don't forget about the throttle axis, okay? So until next time, thanks for watching.